So many dramatic stories playing out block to block after all this destruction. We're going to bring you two of them right now, starting with David Curley, who's in Raleigh, North Carolina for us this morning. Good morning, David.
Good morning, Robin. This really is a remarkable story of survival coming out of this series of deadly storms. Really, it's kind of your worst nightmare. The howling winds, trees are falling, and you can't hold on to a baby in this terrifying tornado.
How could that happen?
Yep, there goes the roof off a house.
Well, look at what the winds did to these mobile homes. Shredded. Inside one of these trailers, three-month-old Aiden being taken care of by his cousin. The baby's mother was napping in another trailer.
I heard nothing but glass shatter. So I grabbed him and I hold him for, you know what I'm saying, I cover him up, you know what I'm saying, to keep from stuff falling on him. The next thing you know, the whole backside of my trailer came down.
Completely exposed to the twister, covering and holding baby Aiden as tightly as he could. But it wasn't enough.
And the wind just took him straight out of my arms.
And the wind just pulled him
just,
right out of your
just
arms?
Just took him out of my hands.
A horrifying moment. Robinson now alone in the wind and flying debris, frantic about Aiden.
I thought he was gone. Thought he was lost.
Moments later, the tornado was gone. Robinson got up in the remains of his trailer. All he could think about was Aiden. And then, the little boy, lying on top of some wood several feet away, started crying.
I don't know what to call it.
A miracle?
I mean, this little baby, 3 months old, flying, and you know what I'm saying? Just flying out my arms.
You know, I asked Jonathan Robinson what's next. He's staying with relatives right now. I said, I'm going to get another trailer, an apartment. He says, I think I'm going to try a house.